Hey guys, how's it going? I hope you're having a wonderful Sunday, like always. Well, we've made it. We have finally made it to the end of my Madonna music video journey with her Madame X music videos from 2019. I mean, where do I start? This journey, I have no words, but we'll get to that later once I finally finish all her music videos. I still have five more Madonna music videos to watch, and I am splitting her Madame X era into two parts, into two separate videos. And in today's video, we'll be watching two music videos, Medellin and Crave. Originally, I was also going to include Dark Ballet, but I decided to combine Dark Ballet and Gone Control and Batuka in one video, in the final video. So in today's video, I'll only watch two, but in my final Madonna music video, I'll be watching the final three music videos on this Madonna music video journey. I will also say that I haven't seen any of these music videos yet. When they originally came out in 2019, I did not want to watch them because I knew that I would be going on this Madonna music video journey. So these music videos are completely brand new to me. I haven't seen them. I might have seen a few clips here and there of Medellin through the last year or so, but as a whole, I haven't seen any of these music videos yet. So I'm so excited to watch them for the first time. But anyway, enough talking. Let's get into the first music video for Medellin with Maluma. That made me hard. The iconic eye patch. I mean, isn't Maluma gorgeous? I just have to say that. One thing, This is such a beautiful music video. Wow, wow, wow. That was a visual treat. I wasn't expecting anything less from Madonna. This music video is just pure Madonna. Everything, the storyline and the costumes. And once again, this is a music video I haven't really ever seen from Madonna before. And I loved the production value. And I'm just a little speechless. It was a visual treat. I was just glued to my screen. I couldn't take my eyes off of the video. There's definitely a lot to unpack in this video, especially the transitions between, I don't know, I feel like there were different stories being told. There was Madonna with Maluma, and they were at a wedding, a celebration, and there were parts of Madonna she was praying in some sort of church, and she was riding on a horse, and there were just other transition shots that were quite interesting. She was alone, and there was like this spotlight shining on her. She was on the ground in the dirt, and there was a horse running around her. I mean, there's a lot to analyze. I'm assuming that Madonna and Maluma are newlyweds in the video. At least that's what I was picking up. And they were at a wedding, perhaps their wedding, they were getting married. And then at the end, they rode off on these horses into the sunset to, I don't know, somewhere. So that's my interpretation of the video. Now I want to see the real meaning behind the video. And it says here that Madonna, as her persona, Madame X, is a cha-cha dance instructor. Okay, so I picked up on that as well. She was a dance instructor of sorts in some sort of dance studio who teaches Maluma in a class and is then shown dancing on a table at a Latin-style celebration. The video also features horseback riding, a chase sequence, and Madonna with Maluma in bed drinking champagne. So I guess they didn't get married. I just kind of assumed just, you know, the white dress. I just assumed maybe Madonna was the bride and they got married. I don't know, but it looks like that wasn't the case. It was just a celebration. It was just a Latin-style party. I mean, who wouldn't want to lay in bed with Maluma drinking champagne? I believe she was sucking his toes at one point. I mean, I also think she started a fire on the bed from her cigarette, I suppose. There was a shot of her trying to put out the fire, which was funny. I did rewatch the clip. She actually wasn't sucking on his toes. She was just licking them, but God only knows what happened after that. It does say here that the music video was filmed at the Quinta Nova de Assoso. I looked up how to pronounce that word. I'm sure I still butchered it. I'm so sorry. It's a palace near Lisbon. And Madonna herself said that she wanted the music video for Medellin to look like a painting. It does say here that the massive Latin-inspired feast takes place in the style of a wedding, with Madonna invading the party by stomping on a large dining table while she wears a wedding dress. So it looks like it is a celebration, it's a party, it's in the style of a wedding. I still don't know if Madonna is supposed to be the bride or it's someone else's wedding. So that's why I thought when I was watching the music video that Madonna herself was the bride. I still don't know. It looks like she might have interrupted the wedding, someone else's wedding, by stomping on the table, or maybe, like, I actually don't know. The way I look at the music video, this is kind of my own interpretation of it, is that Maluma and Madonna met in the dance studio, Madonna being the cha-cha dance instructor, and she started teaching Maluma, they started dancing together, they started being intimate, they fell in love, and then perhaps they threw a party, they got married perhaps, and then after the wedding they kind of rode off on their own individual horses into the sunset for a honeymoon or to live their lives, I don't know. But there's also the question of the other scenes throughout the video, the other interspersed scenes, like at the beginning of her at the church praying, And it says here that the music video starts off with Madonna praying in an empty church room about her struggles as well as hope for the future of humanity. Madonna says she had seen too much and had been kidnapped, tortured, and humiliated throughout her life, but still believes in the goodness of humans. So perhaps Madonna's character was humiliated throughout her life. She was tortured and kidnapped, and now she's living her new life as this cha-cha instructor. She finds Maluma, she falls in love with Maluma, they start celebrating, they get married perhaps. So I don't know, that's kind of my interpretation of the music video. And when talking about the music video, Madonna recalled that it was a really fun video to make, explaining despite how we worked 18 hours a day and it was freezing cold and I had to ride a horse at 6 o'clock in the morning with one eye, I had a ball. Now I will say there are a lot of people who don't like Madonna's Madame X album. A lot of people think it's her worst album alongside MDNA. A lot of people just genuinely dislike this album, and I can see why. But for me personally, the more I listen to it, the more I love it. And it's not one of my favorite Madonna albums, but it's not one of my least favorites. It's definitely somewhere near the middle. I still enjoy listening to it, and the reason being is that it's so different from the rest of her catalog. It's such a unique Madonna album that that's why I like going back to it. And the songs are catchy, I like the melodies. It's just a very weird album at times, lyrically and the production, and I just find myself going back to it. Not a lot, but from time to time. What I also love about her Madame X era is that she's still reinventing herself. This is a look from Madonna we haven't seen before with the eye patch, and it's very Colombian inspired, and obviously Medellin, and with Maluma, Latin pop, Latin inspired as well. So I just like the whole aesthetic of this era. And just from listening to the album and reading the lyrics, you could tell that she obviously had a lot to say. There was a lot on her mind. You could tell that she was very passionate about the music on this album. It meant a lot to her. I mean, there were 5 music videos from this era, so you could tell that it was a big deal to her. So what did you guys think of the music video? Leave your comments down below. And I guess now we're gonna move on to the next music video for Crave. Now, this is featuring another artist, Swae Lee. Alrighty, and that was the music video for Crave, and It was very interesting. I enjoyed it. Obviously, I mean, I'm gonna be honest, it wasn't the most interesting music video to watch, but what I did like was I liked the editing of the video. I liked the parts. Obviously, I liked the black and white parts, but I also liked the transitions between the black and white shots and the colored shots, which was a nice contrast. I also liked the imagery and symbolism of the birds. I think they were just pigeons or doves. I think they were pigeons, but I like the symbolism behind the birds. Initially, when I first heard this song, I don't think I was the biggest fan of it, but it's definitely grown on me. And after watching the music video, I definitely do enjoy the song now. It's just not one of my go-to songs on her Madame X album. However, I will say my favorite part of the video, maybe it's not my favorite, but one of my favorite parts of the video was the very end, where Swae Lee and Madonna are about to touch. You only see their arms and hands, and they're kind of like reaching out to each other and about to touch. And when I saw that, it reminded me of the painting, The Creation of Adam, where we see the hands of God and Adam about to touch. And it's very iconic. So it was kind of reminding me of that. I don't know if they were inspired by that or it was just coincidence. The painting is by Michelangelo and it's one of the most replicated religious paintings of all time. Now, when it comes to the actual synopsis of the music video, it does say here that after releasing pigeons from the roof of a New York City housing block, Madonna comes to meet Swae Lee. The two reach out to each other's hands, which are surged with electricity. I also forgot to mention that at the end where they're reaching out to each other, there actually is a surge of electricity, which I thought was pretty cool. So I think that's all I wanted to say on the music video. Like I said already, it's not the most interesting music video in the world. It's not the most interesting Madonna music video, but I liked the symbolism of the pigeons and the two hands reaching out to each other. Like I said already, I liked the black and white filter that transitioned into the colored shots. The dancing was neat as well. Of course, the outfits were wonderful and I enjoyed it. So officially, I think that's all I wanted to say on the two music videos. And in my next Madonna music video, it'll be the final video in this Madonna music video journey. It's so sad. It feels so surreal to say that. Wow. So I'll be watching three music videos in next Sunday's video, which will be Dark Ballet, God Control, and Batuka. I'm very curious to see what happens in these three music videos. I don't know what happens. Like I said, I haven't watched them yet. I kind of know what happens in the God Control music video just from reading, I don't know, just from accidentally stumbling on people's forums and people leaving comments on my videos and accidentally stumbling upon comments on other videos. I kind of know what happens in the God Control music video, but at the same time, I don't know. So still gonna be a big surprise for me. Same with Dark Ballet and Batuka. Fingers crossed. So thanks for watching, guys. You can find me on Instagram, you can find me on Twitter, you can message me, you can tell me other artists I should check out. I'm open to any artist from any decade. You can find me on Apple Music, you can check out my playlist, and so on and so forth. So thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Take care.